So, has Pi turned up?
No such luck.
I'll keep looking then.
Thank you.
I'd like to buy a horse.
Well now, have you seen our steeds?
I have. Fine animals.
Nothing but the best here. Is there one in particular you fancy? A fine steed. The fellow I bought him from said he brought him from beyond the seas. More likely he got him somewhere in Germany. Leastways, he understands German.
Maybe some other?
Strong and swift, and there's none as brave. He'd carry you to hell if you wanted.
Maybe some other?
I'll miss him. He's a gentle, loyal stallion who obeys without hesitation.
Maybe some other? I'll have to think it over. I'd like to buy a horse.
Well now, have you seen our steeds?
I have. Fine animals.
Nothing but the best here. Is there one in particular you fancy? Strong and swift, and there's none as brave. He'd carry you to hell if you wanted.
Surely you'll knock something off the price if I trade in my old one. Satisfied?
You won't convince me with that.
Done.
I hope I can be of help to you, Knight.
How's the head?
So even strangers know my shame. Come on, then. Come and take a closer look at Vashek the Blockhead.
I'm not here to mock.
So what is it you want?
I promised the head groom that I'd look for Pi.
Well, good luck with that. I've been searching half the day. Although I have been seeing double ever since that bang on the head. So it's possible I missed something.
Can you describe Pi for me?
Long face. Four legs.
Well, that should narrow it down. Does he have any distinguishing features? Like a color, for instance?
Sorry, he's a dappled gray, a stallion, and he's really fast. Though that won't help you much.
Quite the opposite. Where did you fall off, Pi?
Just south of here. Between the fields and the woods, there's a crossroads where four paths meet. It was around there.
Four paths? So we could have gone anywhere.
Now you see my problem.
When was that?
In the morning. Then I staggered about for a while, feeling as rough as a boar's ass. I was glad to stagger back here in the end.
Fine. I'll go and look for him.
Thanks. If you find him, the groom might go easier on me. Oh, and one more thing.
Well?
Pi's used to taking the bridle ways, so I'd keep to those.
That's useful. Thanks. I heard you have a way with the horse that unsaddles everyone else.
Yes. I suppose I do.
And how do you do it? How do you calm him down?
I'm good to him.
Well, I want to treat the horse well, too. But I don't know how, because I don't know him as well as you do. Will you help me?
I sing to him.
You sing to him? What?
Two horses come roaming in the merry month of May to graze in the shade of the apple tree there. The first one is brown, and the second is gray. Which shall I ride to my maiden so fair?
That's, interesting.
I know how it looks, but he likes it.
Thank you, Vashek. I'd like you to show me how to ride a horse better.
Certainly.
I'd like to practice the basics.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Now pay close attention.
This will be the crossroads. So where did Pi go? So, boy, want me to sing? You're definitely the first horse I've ever serenaded.
Two horse?
Second is grey. But shall I ride to my maiden so fair?
Well, you still gonna throw me off?
Sounded like.
Hey!
Welcome, Henry. I'm glad you're here. God save. Can I help you with anything?
I've brought the roan, my lady.
That's wonderful. There weren't any problems with it, I hope.
Nothing too serious. He's a little wild, but I was able to handle him in the end.
Well, that won't do. Sophie can't have some wild horse at her wedding starting a stampede.
But I've learnt a trick. If you sing to him, he calms down.
You sang to a horse?
It's quite true, I'm afraid. I sang to a horse.
Well, then you'll have to sing something to me, too.
My lady, I don't know if I...
So I know how to calm down that roan. Go ahead, sing.
Two horses come roaming in the merry month of May to graze in the shade of the apple tree there. The first one is brown and the second is grey. Which shall I ride to, my maiden so fair?
Oh, how beautiful! I'm not surprised the horse calmed down after hearing such a lovely voice. Anyway, I'll think about what to do with the roan. But thank you, Henry.
What can I do for you, my lady?
Nothing. You've done enough. And now I'd like to reward you.
That's not necessary, my lady. You taking the time to see me is reward enough.
Come now, Henry. No need for such modesty. I appreciate everything you've done for me, as well as your company. And there's something I'd like to give you. This shirt was my father's. He was built very much like you. Broad shoulders, strong chest. It should fit you just right.
But I can't accept this. It's too valuable.
It's too valuable to be left to the mercy of moths. It doesn't fit my husband well, and I've no one else to give it to. What's more, if you were to leave us again, I'd like you to have something to remember me by, so you don't forget me.
I could never forget you, my lady.
Well then, won't you try it on at least?
What, right now?
Why not? Don't worry, I won't look. I'll turn my back.
And what if your husband comes in?
He won't. Neither will anyone else.
All right then.
I feel truly blessed to have you here. So long I yearned for young company. I really feel God heard my prayers and sent you to me.
I'm ready.
My, you do look handsome. As fine as any gentleman. When I was a little girl, there were always lots of other children around and young men and women of the court. It was so merry. I always hoped it would be like that when I was grown up too. But it was not God's plan.
You and Sir Divish had no children?
No. No, alas, we were not blessed. Twice I was with child, but they did not live. And now I fear there's no hope for me.
My lady. Forgive me, my lady. I shouldn't have.
I don't mind.
Thank you. Greetings, good knight. How may I serve you?
I've got some goods here whose owners might miss them.
All right. Let's see what we can do about that.
Can we do something about the price?
All right, so.
Is this enough?
A nice sum. Just lower your demands a little and we'll agree.